Welcome, my brothers. Thank you so much for joining me on my program once again. I appreciate you wherever you're connecting from. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please kindly subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell so you'll be notified each time I upload a video. You will be among the first to receive it. Thank you so much. And remember, in this channel, we speak up for the people who have been oppressed. All the indigenous tribes that have been oppressed in that country called Nigeria, it doesn't matter your religion, it doesn't matter your location, it doesn't matter your tribe, we are speaking on your own behalf. You can equally do the same. Use your own platform to speak out about your plight of your people. If you see something, say something. Whatever evil that the government of the Janjaweed is perpetrating in your own area, bring it to the front burner. Tell it to the world. Let people hear the true story. Do not wait on the conventional media, because the conventional media will not tell the media, they will not tell the news the way it's going to favor you. The conventional media will not bring the true story the way it's going to favor you. They are going to play it down. Sometimes they twist the information completely and get people confused. That is why we are here, saying it exactly the way it is, without looking at anybody's face, without missing words. When we see something, we say something. That is why we are standing on our ground at any time, preaching the gospel. So share the video. Share the video to your friends and relatives. Share it to every platform that you belong. Let the people hear our voice and know what is going on in the contraption called Nigeria. No tribe in that contraption called Nigeria is finding it easy. Not even the Fulani Janjaweed. They are not finding it easy. I mean the poor Fulanis. They are the sacrificial lamb. They are using them, giving them guns to go and kill innocent people. They are the one giving them guns. They have confessed to it several times. where will a Fulani man have 400,000 to go and buy AK-47 and be buying weapons, loading bullets, firing bullets without being finished? It is because someone there is sponsoring him or her. Nobody's finding this easy. The Hausas are in trouble. The Yorubas are in trouble. The Igbos, the Efik, the Ijaws, all the indigenous tribes, the Middle Bedouins, everybody is in trouble. And who is the common enemy? The Fulani Janjaweed. They told us that they are foreigners. Instead of protecting those of us who are indigenous in the country, they are protecting the foreigners, telling us to allow them to take our land, to take our life. They even make bold. The presidency make bold to come on national television. They tell us that it's either we give our land or we die. They are not missing one. So everything that is happening today, they have spoken about it and said it in the open, only that most of us seem to forget. That is why when you are fighting for your freedom, don't look back. Anybody that call him or herself a politician doesn't mean well for you. These people are the same people. It doesn't matter where they belong. They might be APC, they might be PDP, they might be APGA, whatever party they belong, they are the same people. That is when you see them, they intermarry each other. When they come to throw their party, all of them will converge. When any one of them dies, all of them will come together. But when it comes to sharing the money, they share it among themselves also. And they push the promises aside. But when it comes to election, for you to put your signature to permit them to continue to kill you, continue to steal your resources, continue to subjugate you, continue to make sure you don't survive, they will call you to come and put your signature. And shamefully, so many people will rush to go and sign for their debt. That is why we are saying there will be no election. Starting from Anambra State, you can see what is happening in Anambra State. The so-called Ifan Yoba, or is it Andyoba, going round, throwing Indomie to people in the street, not even giving them. He will be throwing it on the air, people will rush him to pick it. They have turned our people to dogs and beggars. They turned our people to dogs and beggars. Let them go and look how other people campaign in other countries. In other countries, people campaign with substance, what you want to do for the people. What you have done. You show us what you have done. Show us your past record. That is what people do. Not go and throw money up and down. When you know very well that under normal circumstances, you are never seen in the street. Even in your own village, you are the contestant. This very person that is riding and contesting now, in his own village, he has not even helped people. You will still see poor people who need help. He wouldn't do that. He's coming to throw Indomie to his dogs. And eventually, because of the poverty in the contraption called Nigeria, you see people rushing. Watch the video and see the atrocity those who you are planning to elect are committing already. You can see what they're doing. Throwing Indomie. How much is Indomie? How much Indomie you are throwing to people? You didn't even have the respect for them to at least give it to them in their hand. You are throwing it on the air because they are animals. They are too dirty to come closer to you. This is just an example of what they're going to do if they come to the house. People that see you as a disgusting person, they see you that you're not qualified to come closer to you, instead they will throw something at you. They can't even descend so low to come and give it to you. They are throwing it on the air. That is showing you how disgusting these people are. They feel that you are nothing. You are not qualified to come closer to them. Yet, you still see some people go. We still go and talk about election. You see people still going to talk about election. Meanwhile, people were... We are again in the part of the world you see people doing this kind of thing, except in the contraption called Nigeria. Except in that criminal company called Nigeria. There is no other place you will see in any country where a politician will be throwing things to the public. If you want to give people something, you package it and give it to them to show respect. Not for you to throw something at people as if they are dogs. No single respect for any human being. And you will vote this kind of person. After voting in him, you will not expect him to do. What will he offer you? You think this kind of a man will listen to you? You think he will listen to you? Go and look at the roads in his area. Go and look at the development he has brought to his own area before you talk of voting. This is why we say there is no election in Biafra land. They can continue to do whatever they are doing. But when it comes to the election, anybody who volunteers him or herself to either vote, to participate, to be a driver or whatever for this election, we are watching. All of them are going to pay dearly with their own life. And the government is going to take their life, not IPOB, not ESN. Because the Biafrans will not come out to vote. We know Biafrans, we know whom they are. It doesn't matter how impoverished you make them to come and begin to pick up your popcorn and whatever you are throwing. When it comes to election, they will not come out. Biafrans can never come out. Once IPOB give the order, nobody is coming out to vote. At that time, all of you who are participating in that election will be killed by this very dangerous government. After killing you, to frame IPOB and say they are the one that stopped the election. They have done it in the first time, they did it the second time, and they are going to do it again. So it's left for you. If you want to save your life, the only way for you to save your life in the southeastern part of Nigeria, more especially in Anambra State, do not go close to anything that has to do with election. It is a trap to take your life. Anything that has to do with election in Anambra State, do not go close. It is a trap to kill you. The only thing we are waiting for is a referendum. A referendum that everybody is going to participate in. And people will make their choice and speak on where they want to belong. Only then and after then, when we will have Biafra, then we'll decide on how we conduct our election. But for now, no election in Anambra State. And to show you that these people have nothing to offer, even in the Nigeria system as a whole, the system is rotten. A system built on falsehood and lying. And the people you are seeing going round and round and go, are still that same people. That same people, those same criminals, they move from APC to PDP, from PDP to PDP, from PDP to APGA. They are the same thing. Same politicians moving merry-go-round with nothing to offer. Even those who are a little bit sensible can never ever be given an opportunity to run or rule or even win any election. The people who are qualified to lead cannot even pass their primary, let alone coming to contest in a major election. That is the system they have put in place. A fraudulent system that have been institutionalized right from amalgamation. It can never work. The only thing that can break that system is a breakup. You break it up, you break the system, and everything will start afresh. That is what we are saying. This is one reason why you should ask out of this very contraption. It's not doing you any good. It's not going to do anybody any good. The more you stay in it, the more they take your life. There will be no election in Biafra land. Starting from Anambra State, there will be no election. All we want is referendum. Referendum for the Oduduwas, referendum for the Biafra, referendum for the Middle Belt, and referendum for any other tribe, indigenous tribe, that want to be free. Let there be a referendum so that people can decide their fate and choose where they belong. That is what they're asking for. This is a foundation, a great foundation that Sulaiman Mazina and Kano have led. And we are holding on that foundation strong. Holding on that foundation with our own life, because that is the only way out. Mazina and Kano has always been the only person who has a solution to the problem in the country of Nigeria. That is why we follow him bomber to bomber. And we are not relenting in our effort. We continue to follow him. It doesn't matter what you say, it doesn't matter what you do. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu remains our leader, the only voice for the voiceless in that country of Nigeria. May Chukwuka Abiodun continue to bless and strengthen Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. May Chukwuka Abiodun continue to strengthen him. May Chukwuka Abiodun continue to give him good health. Bring him back to us as we are waiting very, very soon. Chukwuka Abiodun has promised that he will join us soon. And very soon, he will join us. It doesn't matter what they say. It doesn't matter what they do. They will kill us. We will kill them. At the end of the day, Biafra is here. Oduduwa is here. The Middle Belters are here. All the indigenous tribes in that very country of Nigeria will be free. Thank you for watching. And remember us. Bye-bye. See you again on the next video.